Hello, hello, and welcome again to my video. Today I'm going to share with you and discuss with you why is it important to have another source of income. And one source of income is not enough these days. Yung ating sweldo ay hindi sapat doon sa ating mga gastusin. So araw-araw, minuminuto, yung tuition fee ng ating mga anak, yung pagkain, yung ating yung cost ng ating mga pananamit, yung renta sa bahay, bayad sa kuryente, patuloy tumataas, pero yung ating sweldo ay hindi man lang tumataas. So hindi siya proportionate doon sa ating mga expenses o yung ating cost of living. I think most people will agree with me doon sa sinabi ko. And I think everybody is feeling the pinch o nararamdaman nila ito. So it's a fact of life. Now, if you are really motivated, if you really wanted to change your present situation, kung ito yung nararamdaman mo ngayon, now you don't need to spend a lot. Okay, to start your second income or to create another source of income. You don't need to spend lots of capital. So I think the best way to do is to create soft asset. So what is soft asset? Now, asset is divided into two parts. So it's meron tayong tinatawag na hard asset and soft asset. Now, asset simply means something that gives you money. So ito yung anything that can give you money, it's called an asset. And then anything that can take money out from you is called a liability. So for example, if you got like a real estate, kung meron kang bahay, pinaparentahan mo, and yung tenant mo nagbibigay sa iyo ng bayad for his or her rent every month, so that's an asset. So kung meron ka namang pera, nilagay mo sa negosyo, and yung pera mo, binibigyan ka ng income every month from that money na ininvest mo doon sa business. So that's an asset. And then, say for example, meron ka sasakyan, say a van, ginagamit mo, halimbawa, pagsundo ng mga bata sa school, and nagkakreate ka ng income doon every month. So that's an asset. So that kind of asset, yung real estate, yung sasakyan, yung pera, that's called hard asset. So hard asset means nahahawakan mo siya, tangible. So those are tangible, nahahawakan mo. So those are called hard assets. So soft asset naman ay intangible. So that's, say for example, you're a doctor. So magaling kang brain surgeon. So magaling ka, nakakapag nag-o-opera ka ng mga sa utak. Okay, may mga nagkaroon ng blood clot sa utak o kung ano man lang naging sakit nila. So your talent, your expertise, you get paid for it. So yung knowledge mo, yung skills mo, yung talent mo, so that those are called soft assets. So in assets, pagka sinabing assets, you got hard assets and you got soft assets. But now I would like to discuss about, you know, like creating soft assets, because to be honest with you, lahat naman tayo, karamihan sa atin, we don't have properties, we don't have the money, we don't have yung mga sasakyan. So for us to have that, we need to think of a way, paano ba tayo magkakaroon pa o makakapag-acquire ng income if wala tayo noon. So the best thing to do, like what I've said, is to create soft assets. Now, hindi mo rin kailangan na maging doktor, maging lawyer, because again, if you want to be a doctor or lawyer, kailangan mo rin ng pera. So, but nowadays, because of the internet, change nila lahat yun. So you can create soft asset and then create income out of it using the internet. So let me give you an example. If you upgrade your skills, if you upgrade your talent, if you upgrade your knowledge, now you can do freelance job. Pwede kang magtrabaho as a freelancer. or a virtual assistant, tawag nila. So you can work from anywhere by just using your laptop or your internet. As long as you got a laptop and internet connection, you can do freelance job. You can be a graphic designer, you can be a graphic artist, a writer, you can also can be a Facebook marketer. So pwede ka mag-advertise sa Facebook, sa Google. So pwede mong gawin lahat 'yan. So those skills or those knowledge that I told you, lahat 'yan pwede mo namang ma-acquire 'yan ngayon. Pwede mo ma-acquire ngayon using the internet. So what you just need to do is go to YouTube, watch videos, watch tutorial. Kung gusto mong free, kung say sabihin mo wala ka namang pera at the moment, and syempre ang problema mo nga is how to create extra income, so you're struggling, so you can go to YouTube, you can go to Facebook. Marami namang mga groups, marami namang mga tutorial video on how to become, say, a graphic artist, a graphic designer. And from there, you upgrade, and then you create your skills and your talent. So by doing that, you are creating an asset which is called a soft asset. Okay. So again, what's holding you back is just yourself. So kung talagang gusto mo, if you're really motivated and your situation calls na kailangan mo mag-create ng extra income, and wala kang pera, and then you're struggling, so what you can do is that, you know, you can create soft assets so that those assets that you created, you know, whatever you are passionate about, then it can create income for you. Okay, so again, build your asset, build your soft asset, so it will give you extra income. So again, this is Butch Lirios. You can visit my website at butchlirios.com, and thank you for watching. Bye.